Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's explore this idea of protecting groups. Have you ever painted something, like a wall in a house? You might want the wall to be one color, but the door frame or trim around a window might be a different color. How do you keep from getting wall paint on the trim? If you're like me, you need to put tape over the trim to protect it. Once you're done painting the wall, remove the tape and your trim will still be the right color. Chemists run into this same issue. Sometimes multiple parts of a molecule might react, and you might want to protect them from reacting. You don't use tape, but you do use protecting groups. In the upper left, far upper left, we have a desired reaction. Let's turn this diol on the left into a hydroxy ketone. We'll need to do chemistry at both alcohols. That's the tricky part. How do we keep one alcohol from reacting while we work on the other alcohol? We'll use protecting groups. Let's walk through this sequence of reactions. I won't show mechanisms, but I will show all the reaction products. Okay, first we need to block off one of these OH groups. Let's make it into an ether, which is a very stable functional group. However, we need to pick an ether that we can remove easily. Let's go with the benzyl group. So, we'll treat our alcohol with one equivalent of sodium hydride, followed by one equivalent of benzyl bromide. This is a Williamson ether synthesis. It might take some effort to make this reaction work well, but we could do it. Now we have the other alcohol alone. We can add the methyl group from our product if that alcohol were to be a ketone. So let's oxidize this alcohol through a Swern oxidation. That gives a ketone. We can attack with something like methyl magnesium bromide, a Grignard, followed by addition of water to give an alcohol with our methyl group. The right-hand side of the molecule is finished. To work on the left-hand side, we need to remove the benzyl group. The problem is we can't just use a really strong acid to cleave that ether because we'll also mess up the alcohol, the tertiary alcohol on the right. We need to use some more mild method. That's fine. We can just use hydrogen and palladium on carbon. That will remove the ether in the bottom right. Our alcohol will remain intact. Now we just need to convert our lower left alcohol into a ketone. And again, we could use the Swern. We could also do something like PCC oxidation. And there is our final product. Without using protecting groups along the way, this reaction sequence would have been very low yielding. With a protecting group, we can easily work on each side of the molecule separately to ensure the chemistry will work as well as possible. We'll see more protecting group chemistry as we do more synthesis in the other playlists.